You poor naive chump. I'm going to pretend I didn't hear that load of sickening schmaltz, and I'm going to give you a bit of an education. At the end of it, if you're smart, you'll thank me, and then you'll sign that contract.
Mice again.
All right, we'll send someone over to take care of it. Over.
Look, there is the true spirit of the golden age of racing. Benjamin Braddock, Reginald White, George Wheeler, Diamond Dave Tewksbury, and Oliver Potter. The five most powerful men in the world at the turn of the last century. For all intents and purposes, they created the modern automotive industry. But the true stroke of their genius was the invention of the WRL, the world's first racing league. Interesting that you and your father were so moved by the 43 Prix. One of the great finishes in the history of racing, right? Everyone remembers Burns and Stickleton slugging it out. But who remembers Carl Potts? Driving this rebuilt Whittigan for Iodine Industries, Potts spun out in the second lap and went down as a DNF, a forgettable and pathetic finish. So bad that afterwards, Iodine stock dropped 6 points. But as Ben Burns sat guzzling cold fresh milk in Victory Lane, 1,000 cameras taking his picture, Cirrus Aeronautics saw almost a 12-point gain, which immediately blocked Peninsula Power Cell from being able to afford the price of a complete takeover. This put Joel Goldman, the CEO of Iodine Inc., in the exact position he wanted to be in. By first buying controlling interest in his own company at a devalued price, he then brokered a merger with Cirrus that immediately sent Iodine into the gains record book, the only record book that matters. Look out that window. There isn't a single plane or helicopter or K-Harrier that isn't powered by iodine fuel cells. That's what racing is about. It has nothing to do with cars or drivers. All that matters is power and the unassailable might of money.